There's a poll that was conducted in the spring, which came across my radar, about the healthcare system in the U.S. and the healthcare systems respectively around the world. And man, is this something. So the U.S. ranks dead last in trust of our healthcare system. Look at this. So you can see there, 76% of Americans say either we need major changes to our healthcare system or it needs to be completely reformed. 76%. The only one who's in the same ballpark is Greece. 77% say it either needs major changes or needs to be completely reformed. And by the way, in Greece, there's more that say it needs major changes and fewer who say it needs to be completely reformed. So you could argue they're even below us because more of our people say we need to completely reform our system. And then you look at that, compare that to the rest of the developed world. I mean, look, compare that to Canada. Compare that to Canada. What is it? 57% say it doesn't need to be changed or it needs minor changes. That number in the U.S. is just 24%. So, in other words, people in the U.S. are well aware this is our number one issue. The pandemic highlighted this issue. It exacerbated the problems that already existed. And remember, even before the pandemic, up to 45,000 people died every year, according to a Harvard study from 2009, because they don't have basic health care. 45,000 deaths every year. Now, I'm told all the time about Canadian waiting lines for health care. What they don't tell you is we have waiting lines in this country, and the waiting line is littered with up to 45,000 dead bodies every single year. Now, in Canada, are there sometimes some wait lines? Yes. It's for elective procedures. In other words, procedures that you can wait for. They prioritize there based on need. Hey, who needs the care? You're going to get it right now. Whereas in the U.S., we prioritize based on the size of your wallet. We do a wallet biopsy. Do a class biopsy in this country. Which, of course, also then has racial implications as well. Because a disproportionate number of people of color are not as well off. So, I mean, it couldn't be any more clear that our healthcare system is broken. We pay more than any other country in the world per capita. And we have way worse outcomes. There was that World Health Organization study, which ranked us number 37 in the world. But that's an old study from around the year 2000. But even the recent studies from the Commonwealth Fund, we were ranked 11th out of the 11 countries studied with our healthcare system. In every measurable way, we're worse. We have a rapacious, for-profit price-gouging system. The system is run by the health insurance companies, which are nothing but a middleman mafia. They just take their cut and tell you that your care is going to be denied for all sorts of bullshit reasons. They tell you you can't go to this doctor because it's out of network. Under Medicare for All system, you could pick your doctor. And there is no mafia middleman. The single payer is the government. So you get sick, you get help, and it's paid for with your tax dollars. In this country, we just throw all our money at the military. That's what we do. Colossal Pentagon budgets, defense budgets every year. While our basic needs get ignored. And by the way, a Medicare for All system would save trillions of dollars. We've covered the studies on that ad nauseum, ad infinitum. So people know, man, and it's just crazy that even in the midst of a pandemic, even though the public is overwhelmingly on the side of fixing this, you couldn't move Biden. Forget Medicare for All. He said he'd veto Medicare for All. You couldn't even get him to do a public option. He backed off the public option, which is his campaign pledge. The best thing we did with our healthcare system, arguably ever, is the free vaccine rollout program for COVID-19. We're now like, what, 70% of the country or 70% of adults or something like that are vaccinated? We got a little taste of socialism, and it was awesome. And what we need to do is expand that and broaden it. And that's why in the package, the reconciliation package, they're talking about hopefully lowering that Medicare age. You hope that doesn't get axed in these terrible negotiations going on. But that would be a great start. That'd be a great start. But really, we needed Medicare for All yesterday. And by the way, the propaganda is not working anymore. When people say, oh, we're the best healthcare system in the world, my ass cheeks we are. Americans in a poll are saying, actually, we think we're more critical of ours than anybody else in the world is critical of theirs. So we have the least trust in our healthcare system. The propaganda doesn't work anymore because people are experiencing it firsthand. How many people have gotten a medical bill that they can't pay? Medical bills are the top cause of bankruptcy in the United States of America. Medical bills or medical bankruptcies aren't a thing in other developed countries. You're getting screwed, man. And it looks like Americans have figured that out. So now it's time to act on it.
Ever since Adpocalypse, when YouTube defunded all independent news and politics overnight, we haven't trusted them. We know they can pull the rug out from underneath us at any time. If you enjoy this content, please consider tipping $1 or $2 per month on the Secular Talk Patreon. Link in the video description box below. Thanks for your support.